Today is October 14th, 2011, and my name is Chandler Outman. I am interviewing Sasha Shtern, whose parents, who was a refusenik, who moved to the United States when he was quite young. This interview is being recorded for the Maria Rogers Oral History Program, and the interview is being filmed by Ren Sherling. So, where and when were you born?
I was born in Tashkent, Uzbekistan, 1988, April 20th.
And what do you remember about this? How old were you when you moved from the Soviet Union?
When we came to America, I was almost four.
And is there anything that you remember about living in Dushanbe?
Not Dushanbe, Tashkent. I remember the apartment building we lived in, and I remember having kids that I played with there, and also time that we spent in Stalingrad after we left Tashkent, before we came to America, playing in the woods.
Is there anything that you remember about your Jewishness living in this former Soviet Union?
No.
What would you say is your connection to Judaism today?
I associate myself culturally as a Jew. People ask me if I'm Russian. I don't particularly think myself as Russian, but I'm not observant.
And what do you think was very significant? What has your life been like after moving to the United States?
My life's been pretty good. Seems like my family was assisted quite a bit at the beginning, and that allowed me to, for the most part, lead an ordinary life of an ordinary American child.
And do you remember anything associated with the project, with Boulder Action for Soviet Jewry, or anything like that when you first moved here?
Well, I remember the people that were associated with it, and meeting them and some of their kids. And not particular. Most of my memories have to do with Chag Hashem and spending a lot of time at Chag Hashem when I was young.
Why don't you talk about that a little more? Tell us about that.
Well, I attended preschool at Chag Hashem. And while I had attended preschool, I lived in an apartment. While we lived in Boulder, we lived in an apartment building for a short period that my grandparents also lived in, and then also one or two other Jewish families that had been assisted by the same program. So I remember interacting with them quite a bit, and I remember just spending a lot of time in Chag Hashem and learning and playing with the other kids, building things with blocks, and learning about the other kids there.
Did your parents live in Tashkent all their lives? Is that where your family Yes. came from, mostly?
Yes, both of my parents were born in Tashkent and lived there until we moved. My grandparents had moved into Tashkent for different reasons, each of their own. I believe my grandfather on my mother's side was also born in Tashkent, but he's the only one.
What did your parents do for a living?
My mother taught piano, and my father managed a steam power plant for heating and electricity for Tashkent.
Did they associate themselves with being Jewish in the community, like in your family? Like, were you, would you consider yourself Jewish growing up? Like, what, how strict did your parents raise you, like, in your family, like, being Jewish at all? Was that a big part of growing up?
Judaism has been such that it was always made clear to me that I'm a Jew, and others are not, and not necessarily strict, but I know that all of my parents, I think all of their closer friends were Jewish, and the circles around them were all Jewish, so not necessarily strict, but perhaps because there wasn't much alternative, all of their circles were Jewish, and that got passed along to me, and that I knew I should be friends with Jewish people.
Do they still speak Russian, even though they live in the U.S. now?
Yeah, everyone speaks Russian.
You and your family members, you speak a lot of Russian when you're together?
Yeah, we only speak Russian.
What does it mean for you to be a Jew?
Mm-hmm. What does it mean for me to be a Jew? That's a good question. Just an ancient bloodline that I feel I carry and should represent well. And that's it.
Do you or your family still maintain connections with the people who helped y'all move to the United States and helped y'all become acclimated to the United States and into Boulder and mm-hmm. people associated with BASJ?
Yes, we say once or twice a year have, I believe each family had its own sponsor family. So the family that we spent the most time with, for some reason I don't know their last names. They've always been Randy and Polly to me, so I've never had to even think of their last names, so I don't know them. But Randy and Polly, we seem to have dinner once or twice a year, my parents, my sister and I, and sometimes their kids. And when we lived in Boulder, that would be more often, that they would invite us over for a social function, and often my grandparents as well. So everyone would attend, and the Cullens as well. They help. I don't see them so much, but I believe my grandparents see them once a year. And there's another family. I don't recall their names. I don't interact with them, but they were also one of the early families, and I distinctly remember who they are, and they had two small kids as well that were approximately my age, and I remember running into them. After we had moved out of Boulder, I ran into them at a Rockies game, and they knew me, and I knew them, but not so much. But seems like we keep in distant contact. Not directly, but through my parents.
Do you feel any connection to Tashkent or any desire to go back there to visit where you once lived, to see the life you may have possibly had?
Nothing more than intellectual curiosity. Nothing inside me says my roots are there and that's my motherland or anything like that. So not particularly. I feel eventually I'll go back just to see that part of the world more so I understand it better. But no strong urges to go back.
You mentioned previously living in Stalingrad. Is there anything from that experience that you distinctly remember or anything that...
Well, I think it was only 2 weeks, and I remember playing in the woods. I think some of my other family members were there. Nothing too distinct. I just remember that being seemingly normal Russian life, Soviet life.
And what was that seemingly normal Soviet life like?
I don't remember much detail, but gathering mushrooms seems to be a classic. I don't know if it's all Russian or... I don't know who it limits itself to, but gathering mushrooms in the woods, walking along, going to like a central restaurant, but not really a restaurant, it's in the mountains, where everyone would eat at certain times, and that's it, really. Eat Russian, you know, borscht, they serve borscht, I think, all the time.
How do you think moving here affected your parents? Like, how, I mean, do you, I guess what I'm trying to say is, do you remember at all the significance of the fact that you were moving, you know, halfway across the world and coming to this entirely new place, or the gravity of what that implied? I mean, at 4 years old, as much as you could possibly.
Well, what I do remember is sitting on a, what might have been a futon that had to be sold, and that's when I realized everything had to be sold. So I think it was primarily my father selling all of our possessions then. So I imagine that was quite stressful for everyone, just getting rid of all their possessions, liquidating all those things in a short time period. So I imagine it was quite stressful, and then when I was a little bit older, and I actually spoke English, it was more, seems like, especially from grandparents, intrigue, curiosity, why do Americans do things like this, why do they do talk like this, and I didn't have the answers, and it all seemed a bit strange to me as well. Seemed to transition from stressful period to curious to mostly assimilated for my parents, not my grandparents.
Did it take a while for you and your family to learn English?
I think it took me a year to start speaking English, and probably a bit longer for my parents. But I feel like they had no choice, so they learned pretty quickly. Everybody learned fairly quickly. And had probably at least started trying to learn when they were still in Russia. Soviet Union, never Russia.
I mean, that's almost 15 minutes, I think.
So, why don't you tell us what it was like being a new American in a Jew in America, and, you know, growing up and what that was like here?
Mm-hmm. Well, when I first went to elementary school, school was Columbine Elementary School in Boulder, and seemed as most of the kids there were Hispanic of some sort, and definitely I didn't know any other Russian-speaking kids there, at least to my memory, or one girl later. So I had quite a bit of difficulty. I think I wasn't able to communicate well with the kids, and I just had difficulty overall during my years at Columbine. I've gotten a lot of fights and things like that, and
fights over the fact that you were Jewish.
Fights just because you don't make friends, and who knows why first graders fight. So those kinds of fights, and I remember being taken to a camp. and I don't recall, but I remember going to this camp and none of the kids really liking me there. It must have been first grade or so, but I would always go to this camp and I grew to hate it quite a bit because none of the kids liked me. And eventually we moved to Westminster, and by then things were much easier for me. I remember in third grade, I had assimilated much more, I think, and knew how the kids operated, but still I found it very weird how kids spoke in English to their parents, and I couldn't really understand. I realized that they didn't speak any other languages, but it was very strange for me to think about kids speaking at home in English, because in my world it was just at school that I spoke in English. So that was just a now that makes me chuckle, because I don't know what was going on in my head then. But in Westminster there's definitely no Russian speakers and very, very few Jews. So same thing, I didn't really connect to a lot of them. Later I realized, looking back now that I'm older, I realized that there was definitely multiple periods in my life where in the Westminster community, people were trying to influence me to pick up Jesus as my savior. As a child, it didn't register as anything. But looking back now, I definitely know that there was somewhat of a concerted effort for me to convert to some kind of Christianity, or at least confuse me enough to do so. That was it. And it seems like most of those people are church-going Christians, and at least while their kids are young, they try to go to churches on weekends and things like that, and I didn't really understand it all. My only real interaction with more Jewish kids and Russian speakers was at more of a Sunday school that my mom had. I believe it was my mom and my grandmother had assembled for Russian-speaking kids. And there was a chess school. I remember an old man, not an old man, he was a nice man, teaching me chess, better chess, but I found it not so interesting. And there I remember interacting with more of the kids, but not particularly liking any of them. Maybe I was having difficulty going back and forth. So by the time I had been in middle school, I really didn't have much to connect with on any level with most of the kids there. So it was just I had friendships, but purely on a artificial level, nothing deep. And that goes also to the fact that generally younger kids, for them to truly be friends, their parents also need to be friends, because the parents drop you off, pick you up, things like that. So because my parents weren't necessarily friends with their parents, it was a little bit more difficult for everyone. So that was that was most of my childhood. But other than that, nothing special. The only thing that I wish was different was just that we were in a more Russian-Jewish area, perhaps Denver or something like that. But Westminster was a fine place as well.
Do you associate yourself with Russian Jews here in Denver? Is that your group of friends? Are they similar in that respect? Are they Jewish or?
This is difficult. There were some at my university, but a lot of the Russian speakers weren't Jewish. And to be honest, I've never particularly been friends with the non-Jewish Russians in town. They're quite different in terms of upbringing and seems like their families are quite different, so I've never really connected with any of them either. I do go out of my way when I find when I'm introduced to Russian Jews to acquaintance myself and hopefully stay in touch, but I don't meet very many.
All right, well, I think that about wraps it up, so thank you for your time.
Thank you.